We have question from mic one. Okay.
It's good to see you here, Dr. Zakir. My name is Derek, and my profession is actually a tunnel engineer. Sorry, Dr. Zakir, my question will be slightly not relevant to terrorism, but I just want to ask you a very brief question. According to Surah 43 Al-Zukhruf, it says here, Surah 43, 61, it says, Jesus shall be the sign for the coming of the hour. Does that mean Jesus will come as the final prophet? Or is Muhammad, or Prophet Muhammad, the final prophet? So if Prophet Muhammad is going to come as the last prophet, so who exactly is Isa al-Masih, or Jesus Christ? Thank you.
Brother Doc, a very good question. And you quote a verse of the Quran saying that Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, will be the sign of the hour. So does it mean Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, is the last prophet, or Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the last prophet? What is it? Quran clearly mentions in Surah Ahzab, chapter number 33, verse number 40, مَا قَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَهَدٍ مِّ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَاكِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتِمِ النَّبِينَ وَقَانَ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمًا. That means Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, Muhammad is not the father of any of you men. مَا قَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَهَدٍ مِّ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَاكِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. But he is the messenger of Allah, and he is the seal of the Prophet. Allah is all-knowing, full of knowledge. So Quran is very explicit and clear in Surah Azab, chapter 33, verse number 40, that Prophet Muhammad is the last and final messenger. After him, no messenger come. But you rightly said the Quran also says that Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, is the sign for the hour. Quran says that, and even Bible says that. Bible says in the Gospel of John that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, will come in the second coming. Even Quran says he'll come again. Why? Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is the only messenger amongst all the messengers of Almighty God whose followers mistook that he claimed divinity. You're a Christian, brother?
Yes, I am.
Do you consider Jesus to be God?
Yes, he has the divinity.
That's what I told you. Jesus Christ is the only messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whose followers mistook him to be God. I will come to your Jesus as God later on, peace be upon him. First, I'll give the reply to your question. Because the followers of the messenger, Jesus, peace be upon him, mistook him to be God, that's the reason Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nisa, chapter 4, 158, Allah raised him up alive. Allah raised him up alive because he was the only messenger whose followers mistook him to be God. In his second coming, he will not bring any new rule. He will come as Ummat of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because Allah says in the Quran in Surah Maidah, chapter 5, verse number 3, on this day have I completed my favor on you and have chosen for you Islam. Once the religion is complete, nothing new can be added or taken out. But Isa alayhi salam, in his second coming, will come to testify he never claimed divinity. Quran says in Surah Maidah, chapter 5, verse 116, that, O Allah, you be my witness. I never told them to worship me, but I worship Allah, Ubudullah, who is my Lord and your Lord. So in his second coming, he will come to clarify he never claimed divinity. And even in the Bible today, if you read the Bible, Islam is the only non-Christian faith which makes it an article of faith to believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. No Muslim is a Muslim if he does not believe in Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. We believe that he was one of the mightiest messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that he was the Messiah, translated Christ. We believe that he was born miraculously without any male intervention, which many modern day Christians do not believe. We believe that he gave life to the dead with God's permission. We believe he healed those born blind and lepers with God's permission. The Christians and the Muslims are going together. But one may ask, where is the parting of ways? The parting of ways is that majority of the Christians, they believe that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, claimed divinity. They believe that he was God. In fact, if you read the Bible, there is not a single unequivocal statement in the complete Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that I am God, or where he says worship me. If you can point out from any version of the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says any unambiguous statement, any unequivocal statement in the Bible where Jesus Christ, peace be upon himself, says that I am God, or where he says worship me, I, Dr. Zakir Naik, am ready to accept Christianity today. I am not speaking on behalf of my other Muslim brothers and sisters. I am a student of comparative religion. In fact, if you read the Bible, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, himself said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse number 28, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, my Father is greater than I. Gospel of John, chapter number 10, verse number 29, my Father is greater than all. Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 12, verse number 28, I cast out devil with the Spirit of God. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 11, verse number 20, I with the finger of God cast out devil. Gospel of John, chapter number 5, verse number 30, I can of my own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just. For I seek not my will, but the will of my Father. Anyone who says I seek not my will, but the will of Almighty God is a Muslim. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is a Muslim. He never claimed divinity. It's mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 14, verse 24. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said that the words that you hear are not mine, but my Father's who has sent me. Mentioned in the Gospel of John, chapter number 17, verse number 3. This is life eternal, so that you may know there is one God and Jesus Christ whom thou hast sent. It's mentioned in the book of Acts, chapter number 2, verse number 22. Ye men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth, a man approved of God amongst you by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, and you are witness to it. A man approved of God amongst you by wonders and miracles and signs which God did by him, you are witness to it. So if you read the Bible, we understand that same thing what the Quran says. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was a messenger of God. He was not God. He never claimed divinity. So if you read the Bible, this is the teaching of the church. To understand Christianity, don't look at the Christians, read the Bible. To understand Islam, don't look at the Muslims, read the Quran and the authentic Hadith. That's the reason Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, Almighty God raised him up alive. So that he will tell people like you and people who claim he was God. He will come in his second coming to clarify his name. He will be the Ummatit of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He will believe in the same teachings of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he will testify. He never claimed divinity but said, Ubudullah, worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord. Hope that answers the question.
Thank you. Can we take the next question from the sisters?
Assalamu alaikum everyone here. My name is Revati. Brother Zakir, I'm your great fan. I'm very much enlightened by your talks and lectures on Islam and comparative religion. I have been reading Quran and I have a lot of Muslim friends. I'm from Singapore, born and brought up in India. I have some questions and please clarify. Thank you so much. My question is, can we relate the regeneration of skin for hellfire as stated in Quran chapter 4 verse 56 as reincarnation of new life for real suffering? Thank you.
Sister asked a very good question.
Thank you.
She said that can we relate? She said that she has heard my talks and she is impressed, alhamdulillah. That is the reason she is quoting with reference, alhamdulillah. She is saying that the Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 56 that the skin is replaced so that you can feel the pain. Is it similar to reincarnation and a person is born again in this world? Sister, both are different. What Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 56, as to those who reject our signs, we shall cast them in the hellfire. And as often as their skins are roasted, we shall give them fresh skin so that they shall feel the pain. Previously, science thought that only brain was responsible for feeling of pain. Today we come to know that in the skin there are pain receptors which are responsible for feeling of pain, which we did not know earlier. Quran says that God will give fresh skin so that they shall feel the pain. Scientifically it is proven. Now for example, Almighty God is just. Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse 40, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is never unjust in the least degree. That means he is very just. For example, history tells us that Hitler incinerated 6 million Jews. Today, if our law catches Hitler, what punishment can you give? Maximum you can give is kill him. That will take care of one. What about the remaining 5,999,000 people that he has killed? In the Akhirah, in next life, Almighty God says, as to those who reject our signs, we shall cast them in the hellfire. As often as the skins are roasted, we'll give them a fresh skin. If Almighty God wants to incinerate Hitler 6 million times, he can do it. 12 million times, he can do it. This is an example of the punishment in the next life. This does not justify about the cycle of rebirth. This cycle of rebirth, sister, if you read in the Vedas, Veda is the most authentic book amongst all the Hindu scriptures. The Veda speaks about Punarjanam in Rig Veda, volume number 10, Punarjanam. Punar means next, Janam means birth. Even we believe in next birth. Even Quran talks about next life. Once we die, we'll be resurrected on the day of judgment. Same thing Veda says. Punarjanam means next life. But the scholars of Hinduism, they came out with a philosophy known as samskara. Samskara in Hinduism, it is the cycle of birth, rebirth, birth, rebirth, birth, rebirth. This is nowhere mentioned in the Veda. Veda speaks only about next life, which even Quran speaks. But the scholars of Hinduism could not justify how people are born. Some people are born handicapped, some people are born in poor family, some people are born with congenital heart disease. So God cannot be unjust. So to justify the justice of God, they come with a new philosophy called as samskara, cycle of birth, death, birth, death. Maybe in their previous life, they did some wrong deed, therefore they are born handicapped. This is the philosophy of the Hindu scholars, not of the scripture. Your Vedas are very explicit, punarjanam, next life. Even Quran says, you come in this world. Allah says in the Quran in Surah Mulk, chapter number 16, verse number 2, Alladhi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It is Allah who has created death and life to test which of you is good indeed. So this world you have only life once. Once you die, Almighty God will resurrect you on the day of judgment. That's what the Vedas say. But the Hindu scholars, they could not explain why some children are born deaf, some dumb, some with heart disease, some in a poor family. Because they could not justify, they came with this philosophy which is not mentioned in the Vedas. Same way if you read Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita says that how does a soul change body? How does a caterpillar, when he goes to a blade, he jumps onto a new blade? Same way the soul changes into a new body. Doing once we have no problem, but doing multiple times is totally wrong. Now, I will give the explanation, what does Islam have to say that? Now, you will ask me the question, okay, if the Hindu pandits are wrong, what is the explanation in Quran? In Islam, as I mentioned, Allah says in Surah Mulk, chapter 16, verse number 2, Alladhi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. It's Almighty God has created death and life to test which of his good indeeds. So this life, sister, is the test for the hereafter. Every year when you appear for the examination, the test paper keeps on changing, right or wrong? You can't have the same paper. Similarly, Almighty God tests different people in different ways. The Quran says, your children are a test for you. Quran says, your wealth is a test for you. The Almighty God makes some human beings born poor, some rich. For the rich people, they have to give zakat. In Islam, every rich person who has a saving of more than 85 grams of gold, he or she should give 2.5% of their saving every lunar year in charity called as zakat. Poor man, there is no zakat. He gets 100 out of 100 marks in zakat. The rich man, if he doesn't give zakat, he'll get zero. If he gives half zakat, he'll get 50%. We say, are gareeb hai, are poor man. That poor man is good, in akhirah is passing. So poverty is a test, wealth is a test. Whether do you follow the commandment of Almighty God? The Quran says, even your children are a test. Maybe there's a couple who's very pious. To that couple is born a baby who has congenital heart disease. That baby has done no sin. Quran says every child is born as a masoom. Every child is born sinless. It is a test for the parents. That do the parents yet have faith in Almighty God? If the parent has less faith, he will start complaining. What type of God is this? I have prayed so much, yet he is giving me a child with handicap. A good Muslim, he will say, Alhamdulillah. Praise be to Allah. He will accept it. He will not complain. Maybe God wants to give that parent higher degree. If you pass your bachelor's in arts, easy test, you get bachelor's degree. But if you pass MBBS, you get doctor in front of your name. But to pass MBBS is difficult. So maybe Almighty God wants to give that parent a higher degree in Jannah. Even if they pray 5 times, now God wants to test them by giving them a child which is handicapped to see whether the parents yet have faith in God or not. If they pass the test, they get a higher degree in Jannah. So the wealth, poverty, health, disease is a test. It is nothing to do with your previous life. That is the theory of the Pandits, not of Vedas. So Veda is the same thing what Quran is talking about. You come in this world once, then you have next life, Punarjanam. But not death, birth, this is not part of Veda. Hope that answers the question, sister. Sister, do you believe there is one God?
I believe that there is one God and Prophet is the final messenger. Thank you.
MashaAllah. Do you believe idol worship is wrong?
No, I'm not doing idol worship for the past 9 years.
I
would like to take Shahada with my children in Singapore later. Thank you so much.
Can we move to the brothers section? Do we have a question from a non-Muslim?
Hi, I have a question, very simple and short. How Islam define love? And what is love?